Well, the moment has passed. Back to work!
G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today in This How a Spy Thinks, I want to talk about the circle of life. And I'm not necessarily talking about the food chain here, even though there is like a progression, you know, the spies go after the heavies and the pyros go after the spies and stuff like that. But more so the fact that I was playing several rounds of Upward, and I have noticed as I've been playing Upward that there's certain paths that I take and it tends to work in a circle. You know, a circle, a figure eight, a double helix, something like that. It goes in a pattern, in a circular motion. What I have is I have a pattern where there is one or two ammo packs and a health pack. At least one health pack. Though those who are familiar with the channel know that I do prefer my kunai, so you can do this if you have a kunai without the health packs at all. You know, you just need to have the ammo packs that you're going. But you find these health and ammo pack locations and you can run a circuit and take advantage of a whole bunch of mayhem that's going on. Like taking the health pack away from this heavy, forcing him to use sandwich, and then we shoot him up with the Lotrangeur. I'll be making the most out of these circuits by taking the Lotrangeur in order to help extend my cloak and get the most out of the medium packs that we have on this map. But the circuit I want to focus on the most is a little circuit that I do at the start of Upward, and it's good before they capture the first point or even after they capture the first point and they're working the tunnel towards second. So the concept is we've got a small pack that's up behind us, a small health pack. You have a small ammo pack nearby. You can watch for opportunities. If you need larger health packs, you've got the large pack that's underneath the Eve here. You've got the medium pack up here, and you've got the large ammo pack on the ground to the left. And as long as random demo men don't land on your head, you are free to run around here, replenish your ammo off of anything, off of even dead body drops. But you can scope out whatever target you see fit. If your cloak is good, you can make the big circle towards their spawn and, you know, catch something in the back. Got a nope out. I'm in danger, but it doesn't matter. There's so much metal around here, so much ammo. Swing by a health pack of convenience. Again, I prefer using the kunai, and it looks like another spy is doing the same thing I am. There was an enemy spy as a soldier. That sniper threw his jirate. Let's see if we can get him. Nope, he zigged when I wanted him to zag, and I didn't get the demo man either, but it doesn't matter. We can just repeat this circuit over and over and over until we have our targets of opportunity. There's a heavy. Nothing behind us. Don't think sniper saw the decloak. Let's catch up to this heavy. Oh, he was on low health. But it doesn't matter. Got the stab. There are several maps you can do this on. Some of my favorite involve some really good loops like Thunder Mountain, Man Manor. I was also looking for a bit of footage from Gorge, but I don't know. Upward just seemed to be coming up in the rotation over and over again. It's a very popular map. I wanted to cancel that voice line. I hate that scream that the spy makes when he's covered in jirate. Ooh, have we got this engineer? Oh, he stopped dead! And that's a razorback. Just harass him on the way out. That pyro checked his back. We're gonna have to be careful. The heavy's going for a sandwich again. Let's see if we can do what we did before. Shoot you with my weak little pistol and get out of there. Ooh, heavy's coming this way. Oh, it's not the same heavy. The other one's in behind me. Get out of here. But it's okay. I have the luxury. No health pack here. Let's do a little circuit. We'll get healed over time. Nobody will hit us. That spy is a scout is a spy. And there's our scout, but it looks like he might have taken the health pack. I'm going to have to back up, wait for the spawn. Wait for it, wait for it. I did a video about this recently where there's several spots you can hang out at that nobody ever looks at. I'll have to link it in. Alright, now we're good. We're back to full health. There's a target of opportunity, and there's a spy. No, Spy, you don't disguise and just walk forward. Yes, go on the cloak, but I've seen you now. I saw where you were going. I know how a spy thinks. Alright, pick up this large ammo pack. Let's go looking for a target. So it's not specifically a circle. It's not like I'm running in a big circle. In fact, I'm stopping here on the dispenser just because I can. I can wait here as long as we like until we see a target like this heavy. Oh, he checked his back. Did he hear the decloak? Just hanging out. Time's counting down, but the cart is not moving forward. Oh, it got touched by a scout. But we should be free to wait here. Here's a heavy. He's starting to get a little paranoid. I've stabbed him a lot. He heard a decloak. But it's okay. Looks like the team has got the payload handled, so that's round over. Of course, running this little circle at this location is only good on the defense. On the offense, it's not as good because there's an enemy engineer often set up down there and you can't get through anywhere without bumping someone. But the attackers always seem to run a particular route. They either go over the top here that we just went, they go along the tracks, or they go to the far right. And you can pick them up in any of those lanes, and none of those lanes tend to check each other. The other advantage of upward is they've taken a long walk from their spawn already, so by the time they get here, their spawning warhacks has probably run out, so they can't see the decloak like I decloaked just there behind the wall. Whoop, that was a bit of a whiff. Let's clean that up. Oh, we got a pyro now. And a paranoid pyro who is burning his back straight out of spawn. Things are really heating up, but your defensive teammates will appreciate seeing pyros. Sentry guns are really good at stopping pyros, unless they're in a really, really bad spot. Right at the end of this map too, there's a lot of defensive circuits you can take. There's so many health and ammo packs around in this area. And oftentimes your engineers aren't making use of them, because your engineers are busy building right at your spawn doors. So you've got this health pack here that we're going to have to wait on a second. There's one right where the pyro's going. Dropped ammo packs all around. Looks like we bumped a spy up there on our way out the window. Give a call out for spy. That scout's not a spy, but I don't know where that spy went. Ooh, Ubered pyros, more pyros, lots of pyros everywhere. Thanks for the heal, med. I'll stab your pyro. So there is no set rules here, okay? You don't have to keep running in a circle or a figure eight or running a particular path. Just take the opportunities under cloak, while you've got it, to see what's going on. If things are bad, nope out of there and let your WM1 pyro take care of what's behind you. That's all we're doing. We're spying. We're avoiding the pyros. Okay, in this situation, they have capped first. But, like I said, this circuit that we've got going on here is good no matter if they've taken first or not. That sniper just checked his back. Don't know what he saw. Don't know if I've stabbed him in the first round here. There's a pyro. He's just going to be running the main path. Wasn't paying attention. He didn't even see the teammate pyro that was jumping in. Okay, hanging out, doing the circuit. Nothing's here, so we're just biding our time. Biding our time under cloak. Sure, you could be sitting still somewhere with the cloak and dagger, but Invis Watch is the way to go. Oh, how dare you taunt! Can we get him? Can we get him? Holy Yeti nipples! I did not expect that. Oh, that scared the bejesus out of me. Oh, they're moving the cart. I want to get this engineer though. Okay, there we go. He was in the action. Didn't hear the decloak. No, we're not going to be able to make a play on the cart. Oh, I'm sorry, AFK medic. I needed the cloak meter. I'm not going to be able to sap that sentry gun because that engineer is going to get the near spawn. He'll remove it and all I'll do is expose myself. So instead, let's go for a stab of opportunity. What's here? Oh, there's a sniper here. Scout saw it. Change direction. The guys on the cart didn't see any of it. So here I am. I'm running weird circles, but I know the pattern I'm going. I'm going to nope down to this health pack, and I'm going to swing around my ammo pack and do another loop and loop and loop, taking care of whatever it is I see available. Looks like we've traveled into the holy land of engineers here, being guarded by a pyro. See if we can make some plays in this. The sentry gun should be holding the enemy team to some positions just outside the first capture point. Heavy is fully invested in the sentry guns. He's not going to turn around. I'm probably going to have to replenish off of our own dispensers instead of off the ammo packs. Having so many engineers, they're going to want all the ammo packs. Oh, well, he either heard the decloak or he heard all that shotgunning I heard off to the right. Oh, caught on the stairs. Oh, looks like we've switched out some of the engineers for pyros. So we got engineer pyro defense, which is not too bad, except, you know, the enemy's just going to get in a position just outside of the range of the sentry guns and shoot it up. And that's where I come in. Take advantage of those targets of opportunity as they are distracted. Oh, we got a phlogistonator. Oh, he got blowed up. But it's okay, now that he's dead, I can get a stab. Unless a soldier fires a crit rocket at his teammate, thinking it might be a spy. I don't know what could have them so paranoid. Here I am, just doing my little circuit. Sniper didn't hear it because of the jetpack. That jetpack is actually really good to decloak against. People don't hear the decloak if there's a jetpack or a bunch of flames being shot, giving you ample time to get stabs on heavies. Oh, here's a spy. No, you don't run in under disguise. You run in under cloak and you get out with your disguise. And you definitely don't stop to stand still for half a second. It's too obvious. Stop doing it. Do what that spy did. He almost got a backstab on me because he was under a cloak instead, but he decloaked in front of a sentry gun and didn't get the stab. But, you know, that happens. Everybody misses a stab every now and then. Ooh, I want this sniper instead. Can we catch him? Oh, there's a spy behind me. I often check the back line before I make a play, but I did not look back on that occasion. A spy possibly came out of cloak, or he just ran out of spawn. Either case, I really hate it when there's a scout, because scouts will surprise you when you're doing this. Their sudden appearance, their extra speed, they'll chase you down. Ooh, got a bump. Nope, out of here. Okay, buy some time. Looks like we had one of our pyros come on in there. Causing some nice distraction. Looks like we've given up on the engineer pyro thing. We've picked up a few soldiers now. I want to get this heavy. Can I sap? No, I'm not going to have time to sap as I go for the stab. But I don't want to be in range of the mini, so I hug the wall before I go into cloak. Well, spy came out at the bad time. Did a quick adjustment. Didn't get the stab, but he didn't get the stab on me either. Gotta watch out for that. Hey, where's this teleporter going? Oh, well, the exit just got destroyed. Okay, well, it's worth a check. I want them to actually run past me. I don't want them to take teleporters. I want them to run those three or four paths, depending on which way they go. But I always like riding the teleporters, because you never know if it's in a nice campable spot that you can get two or three stabs before anyone realizes that you're camping the exit. Whoa, bit of frame loss there. Missed a stab. Thanks, Gaben. I needed that. We're a little hurt, but we can run the circuit. So, where do we go? We go over to our little health pack. Oh, it's not here. Wait here a second. There we go. Wait here a second. Pick this up. No, we're not going to get it before the pyro comes on in. Uh-oh, all of our health and ammo locations were taken. But then there's a big one in the back. So all it did was cost us a little bit of time. Running around on the cloak. Looks like our phlogistonator is having fun with the medic. That teleporter got taken out. Scout's having a go at soldier. I don't want any part of that. Spies are not particularly good against scouts. But as time is ticking down, you're getting the idea now. You don't have to follow a circle, you don't have to follow a figure eight. But you are free to roam around this area so long as you stick to those locations that have the health and ammo at them. We can look for opportunities. The spy knows something's up. Game respects game. He probably saw the stab through the spawning warhex before he came out of his spawn. 10 seconds. Better get to cart. Enough of running the circuit. We have to think about the objective. So thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Hey, hack that. Thank you. What is with all these missteps? I'm gonna just jump. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. If you like videos like this, I'm sure you'll like the other How a Spy Thinks videos, or for a more lighthearted How a Spie Thonks videos. Be sure to like, subscribe, and leave a comment if you want more like this.